Hi, this is Dr. Anil Singhvi, and let's talk about chemotherapy today. What is chemotherapy? Chemotherapy is the way in which cancer is treated by giving certain drugs. Certain drugs like injections or tablets are given to the patient, which then treat the cancer cells in the body. Now, this is important that even though the name is chemotherapy, but chemotherapy is just the name of using drugs to treat patients. Therefore, a patient who has malaria, is treated with malaria drugs, is also given chemotherapy. A patient of tuberculosis can also be treated with chemotherapy for the chemotherapy for the tuberculosis. And that is as simple. Lot of times you confuse it that you put the patient into a big machine and give him some rays and all. That is not chemotherapy. That is radiation therapy. Now, we think of chemotherapy. What are the diseases where chemotherapy is used? Now, chemotherapy is very good for the treatment of cancers which are widespread, which have spread out throughout the body, like blood cancer, like leukemia, lymphoma. In these diseases, chemotherapy is curative. It cures the patient. It is also very effective to treat the residual cancer after surgery. So, after surgery, we give chemotherapy in diseases like breast cancer, testicular cancer, colon, that is a large intestine, or the ovarian cancers. And finally, we can also give chemotherapy to treat advanced stage cancers like lung cancers, pancreas cancers, and ovarian cancers. Therefore, chemotherapy is pretty useful for a large number of problems related to cancer. Now, it is widespreadly held or believed that chemotherapy causes lot of side effects. It is true that all medical treatment has side effects. Like if you treat a patient with typhoid, there will be side effects. If you treat a patient with blood pressure, there will be side effects. And similarly, there will be side effects with cancer treatment as well. But what are the major side effects which are specific to cancer chemotherapy? So the major side effects which one can know about is nausea and vomiting, a loss of hair, weakness, increased tendency for infections, and anemia. So, nausea and vomiting used to be there in the early days, like about 10 years back and before, but now there is effective control and prevention available for these problems. Now, we have very advanced medicines, you know, which we can give, and therefore the majority of the patients will not have any vomiting or any nausea. So these things are pretty much controlled and we can safely give chemotherapy to the majority of the patients. Now what about hair loss? Hair loss can happen in a large number of patients with treatment with chemotherapy. Important things to remember is that the hair loss is temporary. When the hair will grow back after the treatment is finished within a couple of months. And then, therefore, one need not fear hair loss that it is going to be permanently a problem. And secondly, ladies can always try to use temporary wigs during the phase where the weight loss or the hair loss happens. The other problem which can happen is weakness. Now, fatigue can really be a problem and patient may feel very weak. It is important that the patient drinks a lot of fluids and takes adequate rest, and that will take care of the fatigue problem. So the another major problem which can happen is the hemoglobin can fall and can cause anemia, and also sometimes the WBC count can fall and can cause infections. But now we have growth factors, and these growth factors are these injections of glucogen, which will increase the blood count after the chemotherapy is given. And this has been a really, really dramatic advance in the science of chemotherapy, because now we can give pretty good doses of chemotherapy without fearing the blood count crashing down and causing problems to the patient. And obviously there are injections which will improve the hemoglobin also, and sometimes we need to give blood transfusions as well. So these were some few fundamental truths about chemotherapy in the modern context, where it is used and what could be the side effects, and how do we control the side effects so that the treatment can be smoothly given to all patients. We will continue this series in the next few videos with some more aspects of chemotherapy and its usage. Thank you. Bye-bye.